Hello, my name is Richard Chambry. This is Rich Photo Books. It's my photo vlog series that I'm hosting on YouTube and hopefully giving a little bit of inspiration to new photographers out there or photographers who want to go and get out and purchase more photo books. Today's book that I'm featuring is Annie Leibovitz At Work. If you haven't heard of Annie Leibovitz at all, I don't know how you've missed her. She's all over the place. She's one of the most famous photographers ever. She's still working really hard. She seems to be some sort of workaholic. She works for Vanity Fair. And over the period of her career, she's worked for everybody. She's been on the tour with the Rolling Stones, with Rolling Stone magazine. She's worked with Hunter S. Thompson. She's worked with all kinds of brands. She's been all over the place. And she's an amazing photographer and she's so versatile, but ultimately what drives her and what you get from her is that she loves taking photographs. Doesn't matter what it is, where it is, what kind of camera she's using, whether she's using her iPhone, a Nikon, all the way up to high-end Mamiya RZ67, etc., etc., etc. The list goes on. She's really a fantastic photographer to go and jump in and have a look at and see what her working style is, how she operates. I've been really lucky. I've met her a couple of times. She's superb. Like me, she's for a woman as well. She's as tall, literally as tall as me. I'm 6'3". She's very tall and very slim, crazy long hair. Really interested in everybody and everything, really chatty, nice person, and knows her stuff. So, as I said, like to focus on this book in particular, because what is in here are the her story surrounding some of the images that she was photographing, all the iconic stuff. So as I said, she'd been photographing on tour with the Rolling Stones. She had been, in fact, so there's a little list on the back of this book, so I'm going to read it off of that. Obviously, there's a famous book of famous photograph of John Lennon and Yoko, the Demi Moore picture of her pregnant, Arnold Schwarzenegger, her collaborations with Keith Haring, and Mikhail Baryshnikov. She extensively photographed dancers. I really loved all that kind of stuff. That's really good. And also a lot of politicians. She photographed a lot of politicians, and obviously with Vanity Fair had great access in, but really fantastic photography with that. And so on and so on, advertising, cameras, lighting, and all that kind of stuff. So she kind of answers a lot of the questions she's been asked over the years. And also, without going a bit too Patrick Bateman, this is a great book. I mean, this is incredibly aesthetically pleasing for the coffee table. And with the typography and the typeset and the feel of the book is... it's a really good book here. Got a little gatefold as well. Not gatefold, little sleeve on there of her at work with her, looks like an assistant at the bottom. So I just wanted to go first to this. The first image was this image of President Nixon leaving the White House. Very famous image. And there's some great write-up. I'd heard a bit of it before. She's been on TV and so on talking about this image. You know, they obviously Nixon leaving the White House, they didn't have particularly great access to that. You know, obviously that was the picture of the day for them, for everybody to go and get. But she managed to grab this, a very iconic image. He's not even in it. But it sort of says everything about the situation at the time with the Nixon resignation. Here you've got Hunter S. Thompson. Easily one of my favourite writers. Love Hunter S. Thompson. Just so jealous that she was his photographer, or they worked together on Rolling Stone on the same stories and all the crazy stories about them working together. I can imagine them being quite butting heads a lot, very alike, very outspoken and that kind of thing. fantastic photography from that when they were traveling about. I think, let's see, it was a, which convention it was. There's George McGovern there. So yeah, they do the political scene and that kind of thing. So I just want to flick on a little bit. Obviously, you've got the stories of the Rolling Stones. That's Keith Richards crashed out after their shoot. And as you can see, there's the setup. Very, very basic. You know, that's white sheeting, one lamp and a brolly, one lamp on the background. Obviously, in a, I think it was in a hotel room, that's in Toronto. So what it gives you is also, she's on the road and shooting on spec, you know, when she can grab them as well, when she can do extra pictures and setting up mini studios where she can and trying to do great pictures. This is some of her reportage black and white photography of the Rolling Stones. That's really, really cool. There's some great stuff in there. As you can see, there's plenty of text about that. The story of the John Lennon and Yoko Ono photograph, which is here. I won't spoil that for you. Lots of you probably know the story already, but obviously that was the last image that was taken of John Lennon before his assassination, which is beautiful. So, and obviously take on a whole new meaning once that had sadly happened. You go through all of her Vanity Fair shoots, which were very high profile at the time. They were always covers and could be very controversial. Beautiful black and white photography, portraits from that era. You got Evander Holyfield there. I really liked all the sportsmen that she was photographing. I thought that was really cool. I think that surrounded the US team around one of the Olympics. I seem to remember there being a lot of that. Al Sharpton, the activist in America. Plenty of stories about Arnie. She photographed Arnie Schwarzenegger a lot over the years. And the dancers, Barashnikov. And this is the famous image and story about Demi Moore. Caused massive hoo-ha. Crazy, really. 1991, that was. God, that's such a long time ago. So, yeah, what you see is a varying of styles of the photography. 35mm, 2.25, 6.7, black and white and colour, transparency and film. And it really gives you a great insight into her working process as well. I really love how she shoots all this kind of stuff. I know, well, maybe not today, but up till recently, I seem to remember shooting on Canon EOS, and you know, she's shooting a lot of that, crossing over from that and shooting on a 6.7 with a dig back and so on. I like looking at how the A-list photographers, so to speak, shoot, and how simplified sometimes it is and how complicated some people really make it. Some fantastic photographs of her mother, it's a daughter. So it gives you a really good crossover there. I'll just tell you a quick story, because if I go back to number, I think it was on about page 100. Yes, I went to an exhibition of hers at the National Portrait Gallery, actually. Well, this is 1993. She'd just come back from Sarajevo. She'd gone out there, sort of off her own back almost. She was telling us she found it quite horrendous and decided to go out there. She went to Sarajevo and photographed that extensively. And when she came back, although these are in black and white, she shot a lot of it in colour, 35mm. And it was all on, Fuji just brought out this 800 ASA film, and everyone was sort of raving about it. And she'd gone out there, just shot everything on a 35mm on this, obviously they're black and white images, but I'd seen a load of it on colour, and she was like questioning us. There was a few photographers there who were dead interested in what she'd been up to. And the conversation flipped completely the other way. She was like, because the majority of people, I think, were Nikon users, and she's a Nikon user, and she was talking about that and the lenses and that kind of thing. And then she was like, well, what film are you shooting on? And we were talking about, we'd just been given all this new film and all transparency. And she was like, well, I shoot everything on that now. All on, she was saying, she shoots everything on, all that 35mm was on 800 ASA and so on. So she was intensely interested in how other people were working, which was kind of odd because we were all sat there wanting to ask her what the game was with her and what her game plan was. She was way more interested in what we were about, how she could improve, how she could, you know, what little, always looking for little tips and tricks and that kind of thing. She was very interested in that. I seem to remember she had a, what was the name of that little compact that was brilliant? Wasn't it Helena, was it? Oh, mine's gone now. There was a little compact she just had that had just come out, and she was shooting around with everything on that, and that surprised me. I don't know, it's just like, it was my first experience where I thought, oh, well, you're a superstar photographer, and she turns up and she's banging away on her little compact. So, and in fact, now you see on some films and some interviews and that kind of thing, like Robert Frank I saw recently, he's shooting with an Olympus Mew, everything. So I don't think, obviously it doesn't matter what you take a picture on. I think there's quite a lot of snobbery out there about that. It's always the camera that you've got in your pocket, which is famously the iPhone. Annie Leibovitz is a big advocate of that. She says that that's her notebook and how she takes pictures a lot now. So she's moved on to the iPhone off of compacts and so on. So, yeah, I think that rather than overcomplicate things and have too much kit and too many cameras, et cetera, you simplify it. And this is a great lesson for that. The book is really good. It swings from editorial photography all the way through to her high-end studio, massive setup, loads of assistants, banks of lights, and so on. There's a beautiful picture of Nicole Kidman. That's in England. It really does give you a great insight into how she works, what she's about, and there's a picture of the Queen. Here we go. Well, you can't get bigger than that, can you? There we go. There's some great stories about her photographing the royalty. Some of them were complete bollocks, and then she's put it completely correct online now. There was a bit of hoo-ha about talking to the Queen in the right way and all this kind of stuff, but which wasn't true at the time. There we go. I love how all these books are laid out. Fantastic. So, yeah, highly recommend this. Leibovitz at Work. Annie Leibovitz, fantastic American photographer. Go and get hold of this. I'll put the links underneath, and you can go and check it out. I'll point you at some other bits and bobs, put other links up there to some of the things that might interest you. Well worth going to have a look at her if you've not heard of her before. I'd be completely surprised if you haven't. But yeah, go and check her out. Really great stuff. If you'd like to comment underneath, send me a message. Tell me if you're getting on with these vlogs. If you're into Annie Leibovitz, recommend me something. My bookcase is bursting at the seams, but I'm sure I can always add to it. I love buying photo books myself. And if you'd like to connect with me on social media, I'm on Facebook, Instagram, Twitter, and a bit of Snapchat. Hit me up on there. We can get the conversation started. And it'd be great to hear from you. So thanks ever so much for watching this vlog. Get yourself onto the playlist and go and pick and choose some of the other vlogs on there. Thanks very much.